हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम एनके जैन फ्रॉम स्किल ऑन टेक। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू एफआरपी पल्टुटेड कूलिंग टावर इंस्पेक्शन कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड कंपोनेंट्स। हियर यू कैन सी सम इम्पोर्टेंट कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ कूलिंग टावर। डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन रिटर्न हेडर, नोजल्स विच आर इंस्टॉल्ड ऑन द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन हेडर। सो दीज आर द नोजल, दिस इज अ नोजल असेंबली। फैन सिलेंडर, दिस इज अ फैन सिलेंडर। दीज आर फैन ब्लेड्स, दिस इज अ फैन हब, दिस इज अ रिडक्शन गियर बॉक्स, दीज आर पीवीसी फिल्स, शिफ्ट एलिमिनेट, गियर शाफ्ट, इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर, एफ आर पी एंड वॉल केसिंग एंड वाइब्रेशन स्विचेज आर ऑल्सो इंस्टॉल्ड ऑन द मोटर और गियर बॉक्स। Let us know how to inspect the cooling tower. The important part of cooling tower is distribution system. So you can see in this picture, these are the distribution headers coming and connected through return headers. These distribution headers are to be checked annually. In these headers, nozzles are provided. So all these headers, they are intact, that should be checked, because these distribution headers with the main header, they are coupled with a rubber or bushing. So due to pressure, this rubber seal may leak, so they shall be replaced if found leakage. The supports of distribution header, these supports, they shall also be inspected annually or whenever opportune shutdown comes to see the intactness of the headers and supports. Here you can see distribution nozzles. This is an assembly of distribution nozzles. Various type of distribution nozzles are available and sizes of holes of distribution nozzles are also comes in 8 mm, 10 mm, 12 mm and in various sizes as per the requirement to maintain pressure into the header. So here you can see in this picture, this is a distribution header inside of the cooling tower, and this is a nozzle assembly, and this is spraying water here over the PVC fills. So these distribution nozzles are to be checked. They can be plugged or nozzles may break, so they should be replaced if any nozzle is found broken or plugged or choking is there. These nozzles are monthly, they shall be inspected, and there shall be a even flow all around from all the nozzles. There should not be uneven flow, otherwise your header can be excessively pressurized if any nozzles are choked, and that may cause to throwing out of nozzle from the distribution header, and that may cause a excessive water fall over the PVC fills and may cause a damage of PVC fills. These nozzles are to be also checked for tightness into the distribution header. Here in this picture you can see, this is a fan cylinder, this, and this is a fan deck area. These fan cylinders are made of PVC. So these fan cylinders are to be checked for any crack is visible all over the fan cylinder. If any cracks are found, then that portion shall be replaced with a new fan cylinder segment. These fan cylinder segments are tightened with the bolts. Here you can see. So these bolts are also to be checked. All the hardware to be checked for any looseness, and these are also tightened here over the fan deck with a holes, so they shall also be checked, and weep holes which are plugged shall be cleaned. So fan cylinder shall be intact with the fan deck, and sometimes these are tied with the steel ropes from the nearby any rigid foundations to stop them across the high wind flows, because during the high velocity of wind flows these fan cylinders may get damaged. So they shall also be protected by tying with the tie ropes. Air inlet louvers, you can see in this picture, this is a cooling tower, and here these are the air inlet louvers. Air is entered through louvers inside the cooling tower. These louvers reduce the splash out and water loss into the atmosphere. If any louver or their arms are found broken, then they shall be replaced. Fill media. So here you can see in this picture, these are the PVC fills, and which is very important component of a FRP pultruded cooling tower. These fills are used to exchange heat between air and water. So maintenance interval is generally annually, but that can be done inspected in 6 months also. So we should inspect for plugging or biological fouling into the fills. Check for damage to top surfaces. These PVC fills can be damaged due to excess waterfall from distribution nozzles or any damage of distribution header. So these shall be checked for any damages over the top of the surface of PVC fills. And bottom of the fills can sag. That shall also be checked. The sagging can be caused by exceeding temperature limitations in the cooling tower. So these PVC fills shall be replaced in an interval of 2 years or as per OEM recommendation. Drift eliminators. Here you can see these are the drift eliminators. Drift eliminators reduce drift losses. The water vapors which are carried by the air when induced draft fan is sucking air, water vapors can be carried over. So that are prevented by these eliminators. So they are provided on the top of the PVC fills above the distribution headers. They shall be checked for any damages during preventive maintenance once in 6 months. If any damage is found in drift eliminators, they shall be replaced. Here you can see fan assembly. So this is a reduction gearbox, and this is a fan hub, and these are the blades. This is coupled through a shaft and coupling with a driving motor. So maintenance interval is by opportune shutdown or preventive maintenance. Check fan tip clearance with fan cylinder. The check of tip clearance is very important, because if fan cylinder and fan blades clearance is not there, then they can foul with each other and can damage to fan blades or fan cylinder. The blade angle of the fan is also to be checked for the sufficient flow of air as per design requirements. Otherwise, the cooling capacity of cooling tower may be reduced. So, fan blade angle is checked at the fan hub area here, or it can be checked at the tip of the blade. Visually check leading edges for wear. Inspect surface for scale buildup. So if any scale is built up on the fan blades, then they shall be removed, otherwise they will increase load over the motor and excess electricity consumption will be there, and this motor can also be overloaded. Check hub end of blade for cracks. generally here this junction of hub and fan blade is a very weak portion of a fan blade assembly. So generally it may failure from this portion only. So this shall be also checked for any cracks etc. If any crack is observed, then this completely blade shall be replaced. Check fan blade tightness with fan hub. Fan blade should be properly tightened with the fan hub, and fastener shall be checked. Weep holes of the fan blade shall be cleared. Reduction gearbox. Here you can see this is a reduction gearbox, and this gearbox is coupled with the motor through carbon composite drive shaft and coupling. So generally variable frequency drive induction motors are installed. So these motors terminal boxes shall be checked for proper sealing to avoid water ingress into the terminal box, and cable connection shall be intact. Gearbox shall also be inspected for their oil level. So if there is a lack of oil level, fill gearbox case with oil to top up of case through oil breather port and cover with tarp. Before restart of a fan, don't forget to return oil to correct level prior to operation, and gearbox oil shall be replaced annually during annual shutdown. Here you can see this is a drive shaft, and this is a coupling, and this is a gearbox. So maintenance interval is generally annually. After high torque event, check alignment, and if disturbed, fix it. If we found any disturbance in alignment, then your vibration level of motor will increase. So we should go for checking of alignment of motor with the gearbox, and that shall be maintained. Inspect for corrosion, soft spots or cuts in shaft. If your this drive shaft is found damaged, or this coupling is found damaged, then this shaft shall be replaced, or if any damage found in the coupling, then coupling shall also be replaced. Here you can see this is a VFD or induction motor. So motor lubricant, use a polyurea based grease with a good grade of petroleum oil number 2 consistently. If grease vent plug is not removed, grease enter motor windings causing premature motor failure. So therefore, while putting grease into the motor, we shall take care of removing vent plug, grease vent plug. Here you can see in this picture, this is an end wall of a casing end wall, and this shall be intact with the cooling tower. This can damage over a period of time, and if end casing wall is damaged, then water can splash out into the atmosphere and water losses will increase. So this casing end wall shall be repaired wherever damaged for preventing water losses. Here you can see vibration switches in the picture. So these vibration switches are installed on the motor or on the gearbox. Maintenance interval as required for trip delay set point, 6 monthly or annually, these vibration switches shall be calibrated, and brochure of this maintenance of vibration switches shall be kept by instrument engineer, and they shall carry out calibration time to time as per the schedule. Vibration velocity of motor or gearbox shall not exceed by 4 meters per second, otherwise that will not be good for cooling tower, because in case of excess vibrations, the failure of rotating component such as shaft, coupling or coupling bolts or fan assembly may occur. Therefore, the vibration of cooling tower shall also always be kept in limit. Vibration switches are very important and shall be calibrated time to time. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.